everyone, this is Nimish. Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk about Drishyam 2, The Resumption, directed by Jeetu Joseph, starring the one and only Mohanlal along with Meena, Murli Gopi, Asha Sarath Siddique. This is obviously the sequel to the mega blockbuster that absolutely changed the trend of the Malayalam film industry, the image of the Malayalam film industry, the expectations from the Malayalam film industry, the box office collections of the film industry. It was a path-breaking film, and 6 years later, so many years later, to make a sequel and release it is not only something that's very surprising that they would do it as a real project, but also extremely challenging and exciting. And one must really congratulate the team for accomplishing the fact of even making a sequel. It takes a lot of strength and courage to do such a thing with such a big movie, and that is an amazing achievement. This film, because of the existing COVID situation, of course, that still is looming over our heads, and the theaters are struggling to open and things like that, they decided to release it directly on Prime Video, which is another huge sort of achievement, a salute to them to even consider doing that, because it is such a big film. It could have done 200 crores or whatever, you know, unbelievable numbers at the box office because of the kind of sort of cult film it is and classic film and sequel that it is. But they released it on Prime, and that is again a huge accomplishment. And because of that, I was able to also watch the movie instantly, like many of you guys and many people around the world that know about the Drishyam brand that are waiting for the sequel. And I can only say, to begin this review now, that I am very, very satisfied with this sequel. This is just something that, you know, whatever you expected from the sequel is clearly delivered. And hopefully, if you had the right expectations, you will also be as satisfied as me with this movie. So let's begin with the detailed review. No spoilers here, because this is a very much an enjoyable film for everyone. So let's begin with all the good stuff about this movie. So much like the first Drishyam, this movie follows the template of spending a good quality 45 minutes in setting up the family life, in seeing and observing how this family is living their life now after so many years, what is going on in their day-to-day life, what is Mohanlal or George Kutty doing right now, how is the wife feeling, how are the kids feeling, how are the neighbors doing? You know, what is this town and the village gossip around this particular family after all these years? So all of that has been explored very, very patiently and for 45 minutes or more than that. And it is something that is actually one of the favorite parts of the true Malayali fans of Drishyam, that they went in and they really actually enjoyed the first half of Drishyam, which to many of us outsiders originally seemed a little slow. And you know, at that time, many of us were not used to watching Malayalam films, so it seemed very lagging and slow. But that was the most enjoyable part for many Malayalis, and that is something that the director and writers have kept in mind. And this time around, because I've watched so many Malayalam films, I absolutely enjoyed that part. Did not feel like it lagged at all. I really was super involved with the family. I was not even expecting or impatient for any thrilling elements to start, for any suspense to start, or any such, you know, twists and turns. I was just happily watching Drishyam 2, you know, from my home, just enjoying George Kutty, his family, what is going on in their lives. It was like a great update for me. So I actually enjoyed that a lot. We then get introduced to Murli Gopi's character, who is the circle inspector that is taking over the sort of investigation after many, you know, years. And everything that follows then slowly, steadily builds up the new mystery or the new thriller element, which again is contained within the core family drama and emotion sector. It does not go too much into the suspenseful feels, the wild twists and turns, the sort of cinematic twists and turns, the shockwaves being sent throughout, the hype being created. It does not go through all of that. It maintains a very steady, calm, composed pace throughout the movie, It drops the twists and turns here and there very beautifully, very naturally, without it jumping out of the screen and saying, boom, twist, you didn't expect that. Ha, you know, we are creating such a great sequel. Look at this amazing sequel with this great twist that we are creating. It's not a show-off movie. That's what I loved about it, that it very naturally kept dropping these twists and turns and you really were like, oh my God, I didn't think of that at all. You know, you don't expect the twists and turns to come from where they come. And that is all I can say about it, that it is a thoroughly, thoroughly satisfying film from that front. What's impressive about this film is the fact that it took so many years to write, and very, you know, credible that they took that many years, because it requires a lot of detailing, a lot of various things that you need to cover. In my trailer reaction to Drishyam on my channel, Drishyam 2 on my channel 1 week ago, you'll see that I you know, spoke about certain things, like how are the villagers talking about it, how are the town people talking about it, how are the inspectors and everyone else dissecting certain loopholes from part one. All these things had to be thought through by the writers for years, and I'm sure they had to speak to so many people who had a, you know, public opinion, so to speak, on what they might do in challenge in this case and what they might talk about, and all that research on what people really feel in real life about Drishyam and George Kutty's story had to be considered to write up this script and to sort of get in the correct zone for the sequel. And it is just an absolute masterpiece of writing, because the way they have approached this film just goes to show the depth of the writing, especially George Kutty's character, that is just unimaginable. And again, I don't want to spoil anything, but until you watch the whole movie, you will only after watching it understand the depth that they have gone into. There were a couple of scenes where I actually thought in the first half, you know, why is Mohanlal acting this way? Like, you know, I think he can do this scene better than he did. But only after the whole movie, you realize, you know, that you need to watch it again to understand his performance perfectly once you know the entire setting and story. So that is the kind of depth of performance that he has given, and the depth of the character and the writing. And it is just fabulous. Everyone in the movie, including Meena, acted very well, and they have actually focused a lot on her character and contrasted that character with George Kutty's character in this movie very well, because she's more emotional, she's sort of more confused and feeling much more suffocated because she doesn't know what's going on and, you know, what George Kutty did in part one, and she's just struggling with the survival element, whereas George Kutty, who is always 10 steps ahead, is a very mysterious character that we all know, and he's also, you know, he's thought things perfectly, has a much more clear mind and much more stable mind, he's much more controlled and composed. And so that sort of contrasting was also very well done in this movie. Asha Sarath Siddique have a smaller performance in a smaller role in this movie, but they do very well, and the same stands for Murali Gopi, who is absolutely impactful as the inspector. You can clearly see him, you know, wanting to solve this case and make as much progress as he possibly can, and he does a great job in his performance. So overall, this was a very, very good movie, and one of the core summary of the movie that I would say would be the filmmakers did not deviate from the Drishyam core concept and successful elements, which was the core Malayalam audience, fans of Mohanlal, fans of family dramas with some thriller elements to it, local family drama. They did not deviate from that by thinking about this as the biggest sequel ever, by thinking about the fact that this might be remade into 5 other languages again. This is a global brand now, especially after the 5 remakes, and everybody knows about Drishyam, Mohanlal's Drishyam, everybody knows about it, so they could have easily overthought the branding and overthought the stylized sort of elements that they could have thrown in to make this the, you know, world's greatest sequel and things like that. But they really, you know, credit to them, they stuck very true to the original movie and the reason why it succeeded. If they had even tried to show off in terms of their writing and their skills and the stylized elements and not stuck to that truth of Drishyam and why it worked at that time, then this movie would not have worked. And I think that is a great achievement, because most people would have said, this is a sequel, let's make it larger than life, it's going to make 500 crores, so who cares, you know, we can do anything we want, we can, even if we have a good story, we can stylize it into so many things. And they didn't do that. They stuck to that local sort of feel and vibe without giving a damn about if anyone else is going to remake it or not. You know, those kind of things can corrupt a writer and a director and an actor, and they really stuck to the truth, and that is my favorite part of it. And at the end of the movie, again, you'll feel very satisfied. You'll have so much to think about. You'll have so much to sort of, you know, watch again, rewatch again, discuss. It is an absolutely beautiful film, is how I will put it. It is something that you would never imagine it to be, and that is why it is very fulfilling and a very successful start to 2021 for the Malayalam film industry. I'm going with 4.5 out of 5 for Drishyam 2. I hope you like this review. Like, comment, share, subscribe, and keep watching for much, much more.